Hi, I'm going to show you how to add trend lines and error bars. So I've got this graph already made, and I want to add some trend lines and error bars. So I just click on this or double click on it, and it'll come up. It should say customize, and then you go down and click on trend line, and then you select the type, the underlying hypothetical equation relating the two variables. In this case, it's linear. And then for the label, you want to choose use equation, and then show, typically you want to show R squared. So this shows the mathematical or perhaps physical relationship between the current and electric potential difference, and then the R squared shows how good of a fit there is to the data. And then you can do the same thing with the other dot. So I clicked on that, and again I click on trend line, and then I choose to you have the equation be the label, and let's again show the R squared. So everything shows up over here. That's good. And another thing you can add is error bars. I've made up this data, and it actually has pretty tiny uncertainty associated with it. The uncertainty in the x-axis actually won't show up in Google Sheets. That's a flaw of Google Sheets, but it will do error bars. I'm not going to use these numbers. I'm going to just make some bigger ones so that you can actually see it. So you do error bars, and you can choose any, but normally it'll be a constant value, and you know maybe five. I'm just making this up here. But so you know something like 5%, five is constant. There we are. Okay, so those show up, and so you can see those error bars, and you can do the same thing with the other set of data. So pretty simple there. One drawback with Google Sheets is that you can't give a if these numbers actually varied a whole bunch, if there wasn't a single valid number I could associate with these, then that could be with the error bars, and that would be problematic. But if the uncertainties are constant, then you're good to go. You just type in the number and tell Google Sheets what that is. Okay, so that's how to do trend line and error bars using Google Sheets. Thanks for watching.